Sega Minister. This is the gun that goes to Sega Genesis. You know, it comes in multiple parts, you put it together, but I don't need all that other crap. I don't need the shoulder holster and the eye look through. I'll just use this. It takes 6 AAA batteries. It came with its own game. Sega Minister 6-in-1. It's a lot of shooting games, like you shoot tanks and stuff like that. See what you do. But it says on the back of the box, it says coming soon for Sega Minister, Terminator 2, the arcade game. I had to go buy it. So sure enough, it works. Works with the. And this is supposed to be the most accurate gun ever, and this is why. I haven't tried it yet on the DLP, but look, this is what you use. It's just like the Wii. It's a freaking Wiimote bar. You plug it into the port 2 of the controller port, and you aim it at this. Put it on top of the TV or below the TV, and that's where you shoot. It's pretty cool. Once again, I can't stress this enough. Didn't come in plastic. I found plastic to put it in. Because you want to keep dust off the electronics. The two major things that mess up electronics, and it's dust and it's water. Shoulder holster. Man, it's pretty cool. Look familiar? See, that's a suitcase. It's got locking ledges. Hey, the reason why I said, does it look familiar is because if you ever rented from Blockbuster, rented the Sega CD before, remember, and you also rented the Atari Jaguar. If you actually rented those things like you said you did, where you paid the $100 deposit, it would have came in that black suitcase. So as you can see, I own the Blockbuster suitcase that the PlayStation 1 came in. And, where the PlayStation goes. I got the PlayStation hooked up in there. Here's my link cable. Turbo controllers. Where you put games at. The reason why I bought this is it came with a PlayStation in it. Now here's this. The Model 1 PlayStation. Look familiar? Good luck finding one in a box. Ain't happening. I got this one in a box and it was broken. This laser lens was doing the same shit mine old one was doing. It wouldn't read, it would skip, you know, stuff like that. So I bought a new laser lens for $6 online and plugged it in myself. That's all you gotta do. Unplug it. It's got one little wire or two wires. You unplug that, you plug in the new ones. Brand new fucking PS1. Model 1. This is the one with the RCA jacks in the back. Audio, video, and shit. But yep, it's got all the, you can see what was coming out back then, whenever PlayStation was first coming out. What was its launch titles? Let's see, if you can see, you see Battle Arena, Toshiden up at the very top, Ridge Racer next to that, you know, and you see, WWF, WrestleMania Arcade over there, right there. NBA Jam Tournament Edition right there. Let's see. I think that's about all you can make out. I see Warhawk down here. I see Ace Combat. I see Tekken, Twisted Metal, ESPN Extreme Games. I tried all these pretty much when it first came out. I tried the Mortal Kombat 3. I tried Kalik, the DNA and Pyramid. I tried Jumping Flash. I bought Ridge Racer. I tried Battle Arena Toshiden, of course, WrestleMania, WWF WrestleMania Arcade, tried that. Twisted Metal, of course, Warhawk, of course, Wipeout, tried that, tried Destruction Derby. Probably all but 5 of these I didn't never try. But yeah. When it first came out, I was a renting machine, I was renting all the time. Rare stuff. PlayStation 2 hard drive. 40 gig hard drive. You're going to need this for faster loading times for Resident Evil Outbreak File 1 and File 2. Now, I did the test. It's like 30 to 45 seconds loading times without this versus 5-10 seconds with this. So 5-10 second wait or half a minute wait. What do you want to do? I got this for that. This was $40. It came with Final Fantasy 11, which I don't care about Final Fantasy. I'm not into those games. But, you know. So, speaking of Resident Evil, you're looking here at a slim PS2. But what makes this unique and what makes this different is it's for Europe. It's European. I can use it at home here because I bought the 110 adapter. It takes a 220 plug-in. You know, one like you'd see on a dryer, the three-prong thing, you plug into that, it takes 220. And I take the 220 plug-in, and I plug it into this adapter, and it makes it take my 110 wall current and makes it run this, but you know, it's natural voltage. But why would I buy this? What do I need a PAL PS2? Why would I want a European PS2? Three games right off the top of my head, I'm telling you right now. Resident Evil Survivor. Sure, we have Resident Evil Survivor here, the very first one, you know, it's a first-person shooter, go through, but the one in America is more like Corpse Killer, where you use a D-pad and you move the cursor around and you shoot the zombies and shit. Well, the European version uses a gun, so there's that. Survivor Part 2, guess what? You never seen it. You've seen Survivor Part 3, and Gun Survivor Part 3, guess what it is? Dead Aim, right? You've played Dead Aim. But I ain't worried about that. We already got that in America. But the one we didn't get in America was Resident Evil Survivor 2, Code Veronica. It's a first-person shooter. Takes us back to, you know, it's like the Umbrella Chronicles on PS2, but for Resident Evil Code Veronica. Would you want to miss out on that? No. I mean, Code Veronica is one of my favorite, if not my favorite one. I love that game. I beat that game without cheating on Dreamcast when I first got it. It was the first game I bought with a console. Loved it. One more, Dino Stalker, which is Gun Survivor 4, I think. So Dino Stalker, what's that? It's Dino Crisis 3 or 4. Yeah, Dino Crisis 4. And it's a shooter, which was only released over there. One more that I can think of that I want, but I don't have. I have all the others. I have Survivor. I have I have Code Veronica Survivor. I have all of them. I have Survivor 1, Survivor 2, Survivor 3. But the other PAL one that I'm missing, Masters of the Universe. He-Man, Masters of the Universe, only was released in Europe. So I gotta get that. It's online for about 10, 15 bucks. I'll get it mailed to me. But yeah, there's that. That's pretty much the rareness. I got other stuff. I could go through all my guns, but I don't want to do that. Well, looks like I gotta clean up this mess. But it's not really a mess. It's all compact, and I got it all neatly stacked in my room in a closet, box on top of box. So if I ever want to play it, it's right there. You know, I think that concludes our video today.